Michael.
I have a couple of questions. Number one is, how do I get on the list about when this policy meeting is going to be held if I'm not a selectman? Because I was a selectman, that's why I showed up the last time, and all the selectmen at the board at the time said, we'll let Michael do it. You've probably seen the commercial for the cereal. Let Mikey try it. Okay, I went up, and unbeknownst to me, one of the fellow selectmen, I won't get into that, had put in an issue for you guys to think about. I wasn't even aware of that, which surprised me immensely, and I even argued against it at your meeting, as you recall.
I remember that.
I made quite a to-do, but how do we know, as budget committee members, that this meeting is going to be held, and nobody from Hampton, for example, has decided to join the meeting? Because I would love to go if nobody else cares to on the Board of Selectmen, for example.
I would talk with the Board of Selectmen because they get that information in the first instance. Mm-hmm. We have a hierarchy of who gets to represent the town, but only if there is nobody who has been designated. So if you want to volunteer and the selectmen want you to come, we send out postcards and they just send back the information that you're going to be the town's representative.
Oh, thank you. Because the political win right now in Hampton, I probably wouldn't be the selected person, but putting that aside, I have a couple more questions.
Can I answer that just a little bit more?
Yeah.
We can get you on NewsLink. Anybody who wants to receive our NewsLink email newsletter, I think my email address is on the card. Just email me and say NewsLink, and I will get you on there.
Great.
And you can also look at our website.
Sure.
And I think that's a very important thing to say, too, is that our meetings, much like every municipality, fall under 91A. So we have to have them open to the public unless it's a non-public issue. So you could come and watch. You may not be able to participate, but you can come and watch the meeting, so they're open to the public like any other meeting.
If I can't make a noise, I stink.
I understand, but
why would I come?
We'd still like to have you there.
No, I had one more question. Now, I know that in Hampton, the politics in Hampton are interesting, as you probably know. We've had a person in Hampton that sort of bad-mouthed, so to speak. Let me rephrase that. Tried to put the HMAA and the LGC and all that in really bad light. And I think that what we need here for the taxpayers and the people of Hampton who are picking up the tab is how you are separated now from that insurance issue, and also some other issues that were brought up. Did you see some of the comments that were made at our deliberative session?
Most certainly I did.
Yeah. Now, that was very unfavorable. I'm not saying the person who made them was wrong. I'm just saying it was not very favorable to you folks. So I'd like you to respond to that, if you would, please.
Well, I would beg to differ with pretty much everything he said. And I won't say that he was, I do think he was mistaken in much of it, because we are separate. As Steve just explained to you, NHMA and the NHMA board provides these services, the advocacy services, the legal advisory services, the training programs. We do not control the insurance end of things. Perhaps many years ago, NHMA overall created those programs, but we are now separate. They have their own boards. As Steve said, we're housed in the same building. We pay rent because we don't really own much of the building. We pay them for services that they give us. It's like the finance services. We could purchase those services from someplace else. So we have totally separated from any kind of interaction there. We were not, NHMA was not named in any of the regulatory proceedings. We are not regulated by the Secretary of State's Office or the Bureau of Securities. We are a private nonprofit entity, a nonprofit corporation, so we don't have anything to do with that. We were not a named party. We were not represented. We did not spend any money on any defense of any of that. LGC did. LGC was in a different position, but NHMA was not.
And during that time, too, there was a very thick firewall between the insurance side and the advocacy side, because we wanted to make sure the funds for those two never met.
Right.
That the communities were paying for advocacy and paying for training, that was the NHMA side. If you had insurance products, because employees' money was in there, too. That state, that went on that side of the firewall, and they didn't mix. So that was always set up, and we're... The money is never mixed. At one point in time, some of the administration and the and governance had some overlap, but that's gone. We're completely separate, independent now.
Well, that's really good to hear, because if you sort of follow the general conception in the public arena, you sort of mix it all together. And I sort of knew that all along, but it's good to you explain that to the public here in Hampton, because the Hampton taxpayers are paying for me to be here, and for you to be here, and for everything else that goes in Hampton. So I really appreciate you explaining that, and that's really all I have to say. I just wanted to make that perfectly clear for the public. Not for me, I already knew that, but the public sometimes falls behind on this. Not so much that we don't try to inform them, but sometimes they don't get well informed.
And I'll try to even put it this way. The Municipal Association created two entities that became very successful. And so successful, it actually almost became bigger than the Municipal Association itself. And that's when everything got spun off. And now they're on their own, and we're on our own. It's sort of like the children grew up, and they're out on their own, and we have nothing to do with them anymore. So, whatever happens, happens with them. We have no oversight, no involvement.
Thank you very much. That's all I have.